I'm just gonna spray these with oil now, and I'll with penetrating fluid, and I'll take the gun apart and we re-oil it later. I just want you to see what I'm doing. Alright, drop your firing pin in the spring inside the breech block. Thread the I don't know what this piece is. Thread it in. Match it up to exactly as it came out. If you're going to be shooting the gun anytime soon, or just make a good practice, turn your keeper screw to lock everything in so that nothing comes out. Alright, now there's a slot inside your breech block inside on a firing pin. One part of that slot is narrower than the other. One side of it. So you want the longer end of the slot facing out. And there you go. Your breech block is reassembled. A little piece of steel wool in there I wanted to wipe out. Alright, I'm going to set that aside. Now I'll take your trigger assembly. Let's see if the thing's loosened up a little bit. Got any looser. The screw for the trigger itself is not coming out with any difficulty. Remember, if you have some trouble getting your screws out, a little bit of heat and a lot of penetrating fluid, WD-40, coil, whatever, will go a long way. Use the penetrating fluid. Let your parts sit in the sun. Get a little micro torch, a little application of heat. Wouldn't necessarily be a bad idea either. Having trouble getting the screw out because of the pressure from the trigger spring. It's keeping it jammed in there. Well, I'm gonna have to apply some heat to that. I'm gonna stop right here until I can get that screw out. All right, I finally got the trigger spring loose. What I did was, on the forward side of the trigger guard, the screw that the sling swivel runs through right here, I applied a little heat inside that hole with my micro torch after I sprayed this with penetrating fluid, and the screw loosened right up. All right, now let's take the trigger assembly apart. Now, just scrub your parts here with steel wool, or brake fluid, whatever you're using, your penetrating fluid. I'm going to use brake fluid. Your extractor. trigger. I've oiled everything up real heavy with hops. Of course, you'll be using whatever gun oil you prefer. Okay, I got the trigger spring in, or trigger itself, and I'm gonna put the trigger spring in. There is a notch in here on the trigger that the end of the spring goes on. Make sure that spring is nice and snug. Now put your cocking lever in there. I'll put the ejector in next. Now, put this piece in next for your trigger that trips your sear. It's the part that sits on top of your hammer. Put your cocking indicator in next. Make sure your safety screw is, or your locking screw is positioned properly. You don't bust the head of it off. And that's it. Now you take the cocking indicator, tilt that forward. It really takes three hands to do this. Alright, see if I can't get this together before I run out of tape. Pull the trigger, let the cocking indicator go as far forward as possible. Drop the block in nose first, front end first. Push down, grease block. While pushing down, wiggle your cocking handle. And it's together. Take a pair of needle nose, squeeze the needle, squeeze the split pin, and it's together.